Hey, yo, yo, yo!
What up, guys, and welcome back to another one. Oh, we got some hail last night. Look at that. Oh, the old decoy trailer. Got some hail damage, y'all. Check that one out. Come on, Fred, here. Let's go. But you guys haven't seen Fred in a little bit. We've been training our butts off. Frederick, I'm telling you what. That little fart has been a chewing machine.
Yes, you've been a chewing little devil, haven't you?
Not good stuff, y'all. Check it out. It's like one thing after another with him.
Look, Bodie's brand new bicycle, chewed. Old garden hose, chewed. Brand new garden hose, chewed.
And that's just the half of it. Literally just the half of it. Decoys, shoes, my Crocs.
Yeah, look, chewed.
But y'all have been waiting forever, and I figured, you know what, today's a perfect day. Why don't we choose a name for the old side-by-side? I had you guys come up with names, I don't know, probably, what, a handful of videos ago?
The old Ducks Chaser. Oh, yeah, she already got ducks on her anyways. The old Ducks Chaser. I'm gonna have a big old sticker made. The old Ducks Chaser. Oh, yeah.
But thank you guys for always dropping your comments below when I ask you to name something or give me your 2 cents on something, just like the Fred deal. It's really, really aggravating, to be quite honest, that he's chewing this badly. It's bad, y'all. But real quick, before we get into our pigeon hunt here, I gotta show you guys the Ducks Freedom Package. This is a little bundle that we got going on for only $35, y'all. $35. Shirt and dope hat. Look at that hat though. How sweet is that hat right there? $35, $50 value. I will link it at the top of the description below. As long as you order today, being Sunday, you will receive it by July 4th, no questions asked. If you order after today, Sunday, even Monday, Tuesday, you probably won't get it by the 4th of July. So, enough. Thank you guys for naming the side-by-side like always. And we'll get to the old pigeon. See old pigeon? Oh yeah, I chose a name for him too. So, we got a couple more things to name. Be waiting for the next videos to come. Let's get into today's hunt. It feels so good to be out here on another pigeon hunt. The pigeons have switched up a bunch, which I've told you guys a ton. You guys have been asking, Bobby, why aren't you pigeon hunting? And they've just switched up a bunch. We're waiting for the wheat to get cut, guys. Once that wheat gets cut, it's gonna be on. But today, a little bit different hunt. We're a little bit late. There's about 20 in the field already. We got the silo, we got the panel blind, we got Jordan.
What's up?
But I'm sure you guys can tell it is extremely windy today. This is what we got up for a spread today, fellas and gals. We have all 7 dozen full body pigeons out. One mojo right there, and we're setting about 20 yards back. But here we are, like I said, we got the panel blind, check it out. Same setup as last time, the last pigeon hunt we were on. And as you guys know, it was a small one. We're not shooting 50 and 100 birds anymore. It's just not, the season has winded down. All the crops are very tall, so the pigeons, the birds in general, are waiting for these crops to get cut so they can start pushing back out to the field to find the food.
And they've split up into like 3 different areas now too.
Yeah,
there's this feed, there's the feed over that way, there's big one over close to my house.
Yeah, they split up. Yeah, they just split up a ton coming out of winter. But usually what happens when you hit summer, they start binding back up, especially after the crops are cut. The wheat, that is. That's our primary crop here in Kansas, is the wheat. And the pigeons know that, believe you me. But what all we got going on in here? What all we got going on? We got my chair already. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Feels good to be back in the blind, I will tell you that. Oh, right behind him. Did the silo get in your way?
Yeah, I heard it.
Well, that was a starling, guys, but first shot of the day. Oh yeah, they got up. They're coming right at us. Come on, man. Come on, pull them over here. Come on.
Yeah.
Oh, they're coming. Ish.
They're fighting that wind.
Yep. Oh, stick. Come on.
Don't coast.
Don't coast. Oh, they're gonna go down right there. Yep, there they are. Well, they're a lot closer.
Hey, that works.
We got 20 that landed, I don't know, probably 50, 55, 60 yards out from us. See if we can patiently wait for them to give us one pass.
I'm not good at patient. I'm not good at patient at
yeah,
all.
Yep, better grab some shells for the go here. We got an idea on our hands. You know me and Jordan,
don't leave us bored for too long. Meaning, if the pigeons aren't decoying and coming to the spread, we can't be bored for too long because stuff like this happens. So before we get in the wind out of the shelter of the wind here, what we're doing, there's 30 pigeons out there roughly?
Probably
30. There's only been like four new birds come to the field since we've set up. We've been set up for about 30, 45 minutes. The 30 birds that are out there, they actually came pretty close to the decoys. We waited to see what they were gonna do. They didn't like it. Now they pushed out farther. The other day, Jordan came here and he did a little solo pigeon jump shoot on a couple of birds, and he was able to walk up close enough to them where they got up and circled on them, and he shot them when they circled. So this is gonna be something new. We've never really done a legit pigeon jump shoot. Who knows? We only might shoot one. We may not shoot any, but here we go.
We'll get it moving if nothing else.
Yeah, let's roll. I just wanted to explain everything before we got out here in the wind, because it's probably gonna be pretty windy out here.
Too bad we didn't have the cow blind.
We did just walk in.
The cow blind didn't actually work.
Perfect. Oh, here he is. Boom.
I led him too much.
Did you?
This wind.
Yeah, we'll pick him up on the way back. Now they're up. Yeah, there he is. That's our only pigeon so far today. Just a regular old blue bar. But a lot of you, you probably think, Bob, what happened? What happened, man? You guys were killing hundreds. Guys, it's just the season. The season has changed. The birds have split up a ton. So we're basically just trying to get out here to shoot as many as we can, which usually is going to mean a handful to maybe 15 tops. That's been our last 2 to 3 pigeon hunts. So I hope you guys are still enjoying them. I know they're not big and grand and with a ton of birds, but we're still getting out here, getting some wing shooting done and enjoying it. Again, me and Jordan were like, dude, I don't care how many we shoot. Let's get out there and enjoy a good old pigeon shooting Sunday. Hope you guys are doing the same. You need to. But to add to that, guys, you guys have been blowing the comment section up on these pigeon hunts saying, Bobby, do some pigeon identification. And there's nobody better to do it than Jordan.
Maybe nobody better that you know.
But he's gonna tell you how to identify a blue bar pigeon. Blue bars are pretty much the most common feral, pretty much.
I was really hoping you were going to say how to identify a pigeon, because I was like, well, this one's a dead one. Yeah, a blue bar. So a blue bar pigeon is really easy to identify. It's got this grayish blue color. I'm a sucker for the color blue on birds anyway. But the blue bar is just with these two dark bars, and you can see it especially when the wings all closed up.
Oh, yeah.
You got two distinct bars, and the color is your initial color. So if it's a red one, it's a red bar. We call them auburns. I don't know that that's actually the technical term for them, but
right,
it's more fun to say auburn than red. But,
yep. So really, we should be calling them red bars. Is that the technical term?
I believe that, from what I've looked at, red bars.
Gotcha. Well, that's good to know. Like I said, Jordan, there's nobody better to learn bird identification than Jordan. He put me on game here real recently with sparrows. I was like, dude, we got to do a sparrow video, but we need to go out beforehand, and you gotta teach me really fast how to identify house sparrows, the English house sparrow, because they're extremely small. They're not really big. You can't see their features of their wings and their body like you can a pigeon or a dove. They're just a lot smaller, and it's all about wing beat, guys. Wing beat will tell you a lot of things, but Jordan and I figured that'd be pretty interesting explaining the blue bar. Now, if we get a different one, if we kill a Czech or just a black one or whatever, we will show you guys. But at this point, I would say our catch, clean, and cook is going to be bite size.
A tree. Another starling over here. That ain't a starling. Starling in this tree, though.
Missed him. Oh, what you got there?
I got a good old nuisance bird.
Oh.
Little starling.
Oh, yeah. Didn't even get it on film. He came cruising by. Jordan stood up. I'm like, oh, there's something over there. Whacked him on the second go.
Yep. First, it wasn't on camera.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah,
first
true,
shot,
true, true.
Done.
First shot. Oh, right there. Oh, did you get him? Oh, yeah, you got him. Yes. Good shot, dude.
I didn't think you got him. You got him.
Well, stay spray and pray, but
well, you know what's happened here, guys, is this here pigeon hunt has certainly just turned into an invasive species. I mean, grand slam almost. Jordan's got a starling down and a sparrow, and I got the pigeon. Three. This is a first. This catch, cook, and clean might be epic, boys. We're gonna be able to taste everything at once.
Oh yeah. Oh, every time, every single hunt, he always comes with the goodness. Thank you, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, goodness. There goes the panel blind.
That was bad goodness.
Yeah, that was bad goodness. One thing about these panel blinds, I've told you guys a lot, is be very careful with your guns leaning up here and stuff. They don't do good when the wind is coming this way. But Jordan's homemade summer sausage is the bomb. Instead of just beef and pork in this,
mm-hmm.
normal summer sausage. Oh man, that ain't normal at all, son. Oh, real quick, you gotta do a little poll. I like doing these. Real quick, you gotta drop a comment down below. You gotta tell me and Jordan what your go-to, every single hunt, what is your go-to blind snack? What is it? Someone make homemade jerky? Does someone bring the propane skillet and do up some bacon? Mm-hmm. I mean, we need to start doing that. I keep saying it. The duck hunts, we're going to have a boat this year, guys.
Mm-hmm.
The duck hunts, you better believe we're going to be out there chilling and grilling.
Are you serious? Here, get ready to shoot. Oh, they landed. Landed one. Get the one on the ground.
Die!
No crap. Dead now. I don't care about the decoy. He wouldn't die. Real quick. Yep, got a busted wing. Here's this one. First one that went down. No band on him. Younger looking pigeons for sure. Got him.
Well, we just completed a grand slam that we've been talking about forever. There, on all these different invasive species videos and pigeon hunts and dairy farm hunts for the starlings and the sparrows, first day that we've had all three species in the bag. So you know what that means. It's going to be a good little dinner tonight. We're going to be able to try all of our favorites.
And one not favorite.
Yeah, the starling's definitely not our favorite. The pigeon and the sparrow are actually really good. But here we go, here's the pile so far. Three pigeons, a starling, and then a female sparrow. But like we said earlier, Jordan explained what a blue bar was, and we explained basically what a red bar was, and I told you if we shoot a check, we're gonna show you the difference.
Yep. Here is a blue check, which same blue color, see? And what they have is it's just sort of a checker pattern here on these wings. So it's just dark, light, and each feather, see if I can get one out here, is half the feather is dark, half the feather is light, which gives them that checkered appearance.
That
so
is awesome.
If it's a red, you'll see the red and dark. Normally, it's just two different shades of red. So you have a light red and a darker red, and that's a red check versus a blue check. And these, the checkered and the barred are the two most common. There's actually a barless and all that. We'll get into that some other time.
Yep.
But these are the ones you're going to shoot most of the time.
Dead! Woo! That boy is dead! Yeah! Dude, my truck was right there and I'm like, I have to pull it right, I have to pull the trigger right now or else I'm gonna blow up the windows of my truck. Woo! That was sweet. When you make shots like that, boys, that's what gets your blood pumping right there. There he is. You little varmint. Ha ha! Oh, that's so great making a good old 40 yarder like that in high wind. Ah, that's what wing shooting's all about right there. It really is. I mean, it really is. Those shots when you hit them and you're, you know, it's like a 50-50. You're like, ah, and you make them. Those are the ones that keep you coming back doing this.
That's what I hit a dove one time. We were walking out of the field. I had 14 and I was like, okay, I'm not limited yet, but it's getting late.
Right. You know, I still got one more to shoot, basically.
One more. It's been a good night, but I've got about 15 minutes left. I gotta clean them yet. I'm getting out of here. Start walking out, me and my buddy, and there's the dove just cruising. He's probably about 60 yards. And I was like, longest shot, pulled up. I had no intentions of hitting this bird. It was just like, watch this. Boom. I had to walk 80 steps.
Oh, to go get
this thing.
Holy smokes. And which
it had a little tailwind with it. I probably shot him about 60 yards.
Yeah.
But 60 yards.
Yeah, it's far.
I was like, far. There's no way I'm hitting this thing.
Right.
I was actually probably more disappointed about hitting it than I was happy because I had to walk the opposite direction of the truck.
Yeah.
To go get,
yeah.
But it was fun.
Well, the hot action has slowed down, has cooled down. I don't know how hot it ever was. It was never really hot, but
a little bit more lukewarm.
Yeah, it was a little lukewarm, you know, room temperature, pretty much. Yeah. We surprised ourselves today because we did a Grand Slam invasive species shoot. First time, like I said earlier.
Dun, 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 dun. Check out that big old pile. Yeah, it's not the biggest pile ever, but we do have pigeons, starlings, and the old sparrow.
Gonna give a really interesting variety of taste when we take them back to the shop and cook these bad boys. What do you have in mind for recipes on these three invasive species?
Well, I was thinking fajitas earlier,
mm-hmm.
but I'm not sure. I mean, we might end up barbecuing something. We do have a bunch of different stuff to try.
I mean,
the door's wide open.
Yeah, the door's wide open. I would say one thing for a good, we need to do a triple taste test on these bad boys. So I think we need to cook them all the same. So if we have what we need to do is just use some regular old barbecue sauce on each one of them, a little bit of your seasoning, and call it good. That way you actually get the taste of the meat and we can actually compare them.
Yeah.
Let's do it. Well, we are here at Jordan's shop. Check out the pile. No, we already showed it, but having a grand slam like that, when we least didn't expect it.
It was going to be a pigeon day.
Yeah.
Surprise.
So, you know how it goes. YouTube will demonetize this video if I show us just completely cleaning them. So, we're going to clean them, then we're going to get them on the grill.
So, we got all three species cleaned here. And look at the size difference, guys. I put my phone here so you can just have a reference. But we got pigeon, starling, sparrow. Isn't that insane how small that sparrow is? Ooh, what you got in there?
Well, I decided to cheat a little bit because I don't like the flavor of starling, so I'm trying to make it better. But I went and made a little miniature brine, basically. So I put some salt in there to help draw out the blood, put some red wine vinegar and some liquid smoke to try and make it taste not like starling.
Yeah, because there hasn't been one time we've made starling that was really good.
Well, there was the one time. When we wrapped them in the jalapeno.
Oh yeah, that was good.
That was pretty
good. The jalapeno just overpowered it. You couldn't even tell there was meat in there. But the last one, the sparrow, was really good. The starling just hasn't been consistently good.
Nah.
I mean, not at all.
Well, I'm going to throw the pigeon on first. Just because it's a little thicker meat, it's going to take a little longer to cook. Oh yeah. Oh goodness, that is going to be some good stuff right there, boys and gals. On a scale from 1 to 10, how much do you like pigeon breast?
1 to 10?
Yeah.
I assume you're talking about wild game.
Yeah, wild game in general. Birds. Birds wild game.
Bird wild game?
Yeah.
Oh, shoot. They're at least 8 or 9.
Honestly. Like, and that's
not
out of...
that gamey, and yep. they're good size.
That's out of waterfowl as well.
Easy.
That's all wing shooting.
I would eat pigeon over any waterfowl.
Absolutely.
Though... crane considered waterfowl? They're migratory.
Yeah.
Okay. Crane's above that.
Right.
But pigeons better than goose, better than duck.
Oh yeah.
A whole lot better than mergansers.
Alright, got all the pigeon on. Here goes the starling. Ooh boy, tell the size difference right there. Oh, looky there, there's a little sparrow right there.
Well, we only have one sparrow breast. We have no idea where the other one went. It probably got wrapped up into another one of them bad boys, but here she is. We're going to let her cook here, guys. First time cooking all three species together, though. One thing I can say about the sparrow right there, Jordan didn't bacon wrap that bad boy for a reason. Sparrow is really good.
Ooh, cooking quick there, eh?
Oh, yeah. This little guy's been on for all about 8 seconds, it seems. Well, okay, 20 seconds, and he's about done.
A little sparrow right there is about done.
Here we are. They are all done.
Look at that.
I know. It is beautiful, isn't it? Show them. Show the folks at home what we're working with here, Jordan.
Play some sassy music right here. Done.
All right, well, we are done here. We're all cooled off. And what we're going to start with, both of us, oh, that's your part.
Yep.
We only have one sparrow breast. So cheers. Cheers, buddy.
Dink. I still like it.
Wow. Wow. When it hit my tongue, I went, ooh. But then when I chewed on it, the meat. Okay. So real quick on the sparrow, he did season it quite well. But even like on one of the last catch and cooks you seen with the starling, man, you get into the meat and you automatically your taste buds go, no, Bobby, no. At least on sparrow,
it's good.
It's good meat.
Like, I mean, I'd say it's really similar to dove.
Yeah, it's like very, very similar.
You know how it has that just a little bit of gamey flavor?
Yeah.
It's a little bit dark, but it tastes kind of like dove. And I like dove, so.
All right, so game plan here. We're going straight to the bacon wrapped starling is what this is here. All right, bacon wrapped starling. We're gonna give her a full send. Let me get through the bacon real quick. The bacon is really good, by the way.
I double wrapped it.
I mean, when you double wrap anything, it's edible. Oh, there it is. There it is.
I'm gonna make up for it and I'm gonna eat one playing.
Not bad, not bad. So now, Jordan's being the brave one and he's gonna eat a non-bacon wrapped starling. It is seasoned though.
It is seasoned. I've tried this twice and I still feel like an idiot because I'm gonna try it again.
Yep. But the last one, you didn't do the wine and all that stuff.
No, I didn't brine it last time, so who knows? Maybe it'll be better.
Yeah. Not good. Horrible. Cut the video. All right, so Jordan just brought up something really, really, really intriguing. You guys remember the last starling, the last solo starling hunt that I did by myself? It had just got done raining, and all the starlings were hitting the fields because they were searching for worms. Jordan just brought up a good idea. He was like, I think the starlings are so bad because they're the ones that are always eating the worms.
Eating worms, eating bugs. When I see sparrows or pigeons or dove eating, it's always grains, you know, other seeds, stuff like that. I don't see them out digging for worms and stuff like that. Starlings, they eat that stuff, and I think that's why they taste nasty.
Literally, I'd have to agree. Yep. Seriously, because pigeons, they don't eat worms. They eat grain. I mean, honestly, when have you ever opened up a gullet of a pigeon and there's a worm or a grub or anything like that in there?
Never.
It's always grains. So, last but not least, we're going to move on to the bacon-wrapped pigeon. I grabbed the biggest one. It's definitely done. Looking juicy. Mm-hmm. Oh, you're taking... Oh, took it all.
It's going to be good.
I'll take it all. That's going to be a mouthful. Mmm. Mmm.
There's a lot to get through.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Good stuff right there. Ooh, you got a habanero?
Yeah. Want half?
Oh, God. Habanero? Uh-oh. You're going to start coughing. All right, out of all three of our Grand Slam species, which was the best?
Ooh. Man, starling's obviously the worst. But between the sparrow and the pigeon, that's about as close to a draw as I can get.
Oh, yeah.
The sparrow's really nice because it's bite-sized, well, a third of a bite size.
Yeah, it's like barely bite-sized.
Yeah. The pigeon, you have two or three bites, so I might actually go sparrow, pigeon, starling.
I am going to agree. And not because you said it first, but I'd have to say every bite that I've ever had of sparrow, which is only two different hunts now, two different videos, every single one is good. I mean, is really, really good. Pigeon, it's good, but it's always pigeon. Sparrow, you taste it and you're like, wow, is that like ribeye? Because honestly, the meat is that good. But thank you to Jordan yet again, not only going on the hunt with me, providing this video for y'all, but also
allowing us to do the catch and cook here at his place.
Thank you,
no
man.
No problem at all, man. It's
much
fun.
Appreciated.
It's a good time.
Still got to get his channel going. If y'all want Jordan's YouTube channel going, you better drop a comment down below and let him know, because he reads all these comments too. But thanks for the view, guys. Thanks for all your support. Hit that thumbs up button if you like this video. And if you have any recommendations for any other great videos, let me know down below. But we will see you on the next one. Have a good one, y'all. Peace.